How's it going, internets? I hope you're having a lovely day. It's that time again. It's time to get creative. It's time to get into some animation. Time to get that imagination running wild. And it's time to get inspired. And today's inspiration comes from Bob Larkin. If you're not familiar with his work, check right over here. How I kind of got to know him was through, as I've mentioned before, I'm a huge Conan fan. And he worked on the Savage Sword of Conan. And he also worked on a bunch of other Marvel properties and movie properties. And just been a really prolific career of some great artwork. So I figured I'd share a couple of those with you. This is a movie poster he did from the movie Piranha, and I just love it. Very Jaws-esque, but still such a great cover there. This is from, he did some like romance novels and stuff too, but all of his work, like you can see, it's very prolific. It doesn't matter what kind of medium he's using or what the subject matter is, he kind of can be a jack of all trades in that way. Like this Toxic Avenger poster too. I thought that was really great, and the little tutu and everything. It would have been a really fun one to draw, I'm sure. But like I said, everything that he does is really just spot on. This is one, another one from Planet of the Apes. This is concept art for a toy from, I believe, Batman Forever. I think that's the right Batman. But he's just done so much great stuff. This is another one from Battlestar Galactica. Just some really iconic and wonderful franchises that he's worked for and created amazing work for. So definitely check him out. But I wanted to share a little quote of his with you guys today. It's something a little bit different, but here goes. The biggest problem for me wasn't painting the actors. I do that stuff all the time. It was drawing that space station. Having to draw all those solar panels and little details made me nuts, especially when I get a call from the art director asking if I could turn around a painting in 2 or 3 days. And I thought this was an interesting quote because it's something that we haven't really talked about, as far as I can remember. I've done these for a couple months now, so who knows, but I don't think we have. And this was about that some people are going to have certain strengths and other people are going to have certain weaknesses or certain penchants towards or a favorite style or type of thing they like to do. And everyone's got their gifts and you know, things they struggle with. And it's strange to think that like someone could render like an actor and a face and all this stuff really beautifully and easy and naturally, but then to do just windows, which would seem kind of small, and like have that be their struggle. So don't worry, whatever it is that you struggle with, chances are there's something that you're really great at. And everybody has that. Yours may be the opposite. Maybe you're really good at all the detail stuff and the layout and the composition, but you struggle with your anatomy or something like that. So it's really, we've talked about that aspect before of finding those things that you're not so good at and turning those weaknesses into strengths by just punching at it and punching at it until it becomes natural. But I thought that was an interesting kind of quote. And also, it kind of hints around to that part, that production kind of cycle of being able to turn around work as soon as it's needed, and sometimes that can be frustrating and difficult and hard, but that's part of the job too. So I thought that would be kind of a fun thing to talk about, something a little bit different. And this is the Lime Man rig. It's a free rig you can grab over at Creative Crash. If you're not familiar with what we do here, we give ourselves 48 frames. It's 2 seconds of animation. I go off and I find a different rig that I've never used before. It's a free resource for you guys to play around with. And we kind of go from there, a little bit over the shoulder, just hang out with me while hang out while I animate with me. The main goal of these videos is to help you guys feel like you're not alone in your art day, that you have another buddy there with you through all the successes and all the failures, and trying to keep you motivated and encouraged. And the main goal of these is just to hopefully inspire you guys to go off and create your own stuff. Whether it's because you see something, you learn something, you want to try it out here, or an idea sparks something, or you're like, you know what, I like that, but I could do it better. Anyway, I'm really just trying to help you get, keep you guys encouraged and motivated and inspired. So that being said, let's go ahead and dive right in. And for this video, we are using Autodesk Maya 2014. I used to use 2010 fairly often, but kind of just sticking to 2014 these days. There are newer versions. Like always, there will be more in the description below for a link to this rig, a link to more stuff about Bob Larkin, and a link to Maya as well. As well as I usually, I think I always link to some great book resources that are really helpful for me that I still go back and look at and check out all the time too. So definitely. For this one, I thought we'd kind of do like a little dance cycle. That will work out here. Make sure we set the new curves, nerve surfaces, and polygon select. We'll go ahead and save everything. And go ahead and go to zero. And set our first key there. Now, first thing I want to do is get this main ball unit going. So I can bring it down. Tilt and kick one leg out, and tilt and kick the other leg out, and then do a little bounce in between. So, let's get our graph editor out here. Let's check those translate lines. I feel like they're going pretty well. I don't want them to be super even, but fairly average. Okay. Fix it so we're not easing in and out of that loop here. So it loops a little better. Okay, and then we'll go ahead and do some rotate Z over there. Oh, actually, over here. Sure, that's a fairly even amount on both sides here. I'll start building the main focus of this. We want it to kick up and out here. And this one. Let's see. Okay, now I want this to be quicker. So let's take 3 frames and we'll hold that for 3 frames. And then we'll bring it back 3 frames earlier so it's a little bit shorter. Okay, and then again we'll hold that for 3 frames and bring it back 3 frames before. Let's go ahead and look at our timing now. Let's go 7. And let's go ahead and pull that up so it'll go up and out. Let's go ahead and go to this side, so we'll go so both steps feel about the same. Okay, now let's kind of compare the height on those two steps here. Okay, and let's still be able to get a little bit of an arc there. So let's curve these a little bit more. Let's go 2 frames ahead and we'll keep it up a little bit higher still. So it'll really plant down. And we'll just do that on the plant here. So that way we have a little bit of variation from when the foot's lifting off to when it's planting. It's planting a little harder when it lifts off. Okay, and let's go ahead and go here. And we'll go ahead and rotate the foot down. Let's see. No, I think we want to do something different here. I think we want this to be rotated at Z, and then rotate X. It's going to see that now. Kind of loosen it up there. Okay, and let's start building this one. Down and there. Starting to feel good. A little bit loose. I think the translate Y still might feel a little bit too high on the left screen, left foot here. So I'll go ahead and pull that back a little bit more. Still trying to get a good curve on here. So it doesn't jankify. Let's see here. And let's go ahead and since we're gonna translate wise, let's make sure. This one here is maybe a bigger dip down. So I got a little dip, then a big dip. Let's see how it feels. I still want to keep that first one. Now let's also go ahead and exaggerate the ups here even higher too. Let's hit sub 12. Let's see if we have a foot roll here that we can lean up on. just do that. From 9 to 12 to back to 15. Let's zero that out there. And we'll do it on the other side here. So we'll do some football here. And zero that out there. Let's do a little bit less of that. It feels like it's really a little poppy. So let's take what we have and we'll just tone it back a little bit more. Let's see here. Okay, now let's look at the toe. Let's go ahead and let's see toe flat. Let's drag it down here. Sooner, have it like kind of slam down in there. Let's see. Okay, well, let's go ahead and do the same thing kind of on this foot. So I'll go ahead and drag that toe flap down there, lift it up here. This guy, and let's go, let's rotate it a little bit that way, let's zero that out, and we'll rotate a little bit that way, and we'll zero it out. So let's go ahead and see that. There. Feels pretty good. Let's see what we can do here. Let's go ahead and save our file. I haven't done that for a little while. Let's go with 3 here. See if we can do a little. Drag there and down. It's got a little bit of squash and stretch here. And we'll probably minimize this a lot too, but we'll see here. Let's go and see. histogram. There's two controllers here, so I'm just grabbing the bottom one instead of this one. So let's go ahead and stick with the 6 for this. So go down, up, go down, up, down, up, down, up. So let's see now. Let's go ahead and delay this 2 frames. Let's see. I'm only bring the 1 frame. Let's try putting it on 3. Let's see. Let's go ahead and minimize that. No, minimize the top as well. I think that's a better approach to go with. And we'll go back to 0 and leave it out there. See if we can't get a little bit of this rotate in here. So this will go ahead and rotate forward. Is that gonna do anything here? Back. Forward. Back. Forward. Back. Just do a little bit of this. I think it'll just loosen it up. It's not really going to do too much here. That'll help keep that feeling that there's a bottom portion to that hip there. See what else we can spice in there, pepper in there. Let's save that. And let's see. What can we do here? We could do a little bit of rotate to the event. Could do a little bit of recoil after that. So like when that goes up and it goes down, then the toe would tip up and then go down here. So let's see. Toe, zero that out. So as the toe goes, so heel hits and then the toe Let's just shrink it down. Felt like it was too fast, but maybe it's just too much. So see, there's a little bit of recoil when it lifts up. And then when the heel lifts up, then we get a little bit of recoil on the toe. So it goes up, down, and flops. Kind of a little bit of a ripple effect in that foot. Okay, now let's go ahead and do that same thing to this other side. Keeps that foot alive a little bit more. Now let's compare them. I feel like this one's probably the better of the two. So let's grab a toe flap there, a toe flap there. And again, you see this one that's really spiked up. Okay, great. Go ahead and bring that back down so it's more even with that toe flap there. Let's go and see that. Just a little hint more. Yeah, that's kind of fun. I think that'll do. There's definitely much more tweaks you can do to it, but I think it's working all right. So let's go ahead and let's see our file. A little bit of a shorter one than I guess today, but a little bit of a different idea and a little more simple rig. I think that's a fun one to try out here. So let me know down below if there were things that you thought worked in here that were fun, or if you would have done stuff different. What a quick little kind of bouncy groove dance here. I'll go ahead and assign a new material to that, put Lambert on it, go, let's see, go somewhere. So we have a different colored background here, and let's turn our curves off. Let's go look at that now. It's always fun if you can kind of have a beat or a little bit of an idea of a song in your head that you can kind of sing to see if it's kind of hitting that same rhythm or that same feeling to it. At least for myself, it definitely helps if I can add sound effects or like a little mini song or beat or something in there. Then it helps me to keep it and see if it feels like it's a rhythm following. You know, that kind of a thing. I think that definitely helps for myself to get a good rhythm and a good beat to feeling of how you want a shot to work. So that being said, let's go ahead and take a look back at where we started really getting Bob Larkin, and he said, the biggest problem for me wasn't painting the actors. I do that stuff all the time. It was drawing that space station. Having to draw all those solar panels and little details made me nuts, especially when I get a call from the art director asking if I could turn around a painting in 2 or 3 days. And I think it's a great thing to see people who've done amazing work and how they talk about, you know, their strengths and their weaknesses. I think for myself, it definitely encourages me to go, you know what, okay, if someone who does amazing work has their things that they're they feel like this is where they're really strong at or where they're really comfortable with, and they talk about areas where they're not, it helps me to better understand that. Of course, there's, even when you're like a master of your craft and you can work in any sort of medium and you can do any kind of subject matter, that you still have those areas where you're struggling or you get frustrated and stuff. It just helps keep me encouraged, and hopefully it does you guys as well, to see people who are doing phenomenal work still have their tough moments or their struggling bits in their pieces of work. So that being said, thanks again for watching. You guys are amazing. I love you lots. If you do end up using this rig, definitely share it down below so I can see the amazing stuff you guys came up with. And keep going. You guys are great. I know you can do it. I believe in you. Keep progressing every day. And that being said, we will see you for some more animation tomorrow.